I'm Bosha Berry. I'm a writer. I'm a community worker and I'm a social entrepreneur with the African Youth Writers Organization. Most school children in deprived communities in Ghana are unable to read and write and express themselves. They find learning very boring. This situation has motivated me to set up my social venture Arrow to get children to read and write through fun, innovative ways. My social venture Arrow is an innovative platform that allows students to read and write through an incubator program called the Funky Read Write Clinic. Funky Read Clinic features a reading program and a creative writing program. The reading program uses fun activities such as card games, technology, ebook readers to get children excited about reading, whilst the creative writing program features an online writing program that links children to mentors who are top African writers across the world. What is unique about my social venture? It's because it's innovative. We keep on looking for strategies just to make sure that the learning process of children are exciting, are fun, and that when they go back home, they'll be able to replicate whatever they've learned at the clinic. It's bold. We are not just looking at putting books in the hands of children, but we are making sure that children pick up their habits and sustain their interest in reading for pleasure and practicing creative writing, because we believe that this would stimulate their imagination and open up their world to possible opportunities. Status quo. We are changing the system. This organization is a system change because we are just not teaching children their skills, but we are grooming them. We are grooming avid readers and prolific writers, and children passing through the clinic will have an opportunity to even pick up creative writing as a possible career option. So we are giving children leisure and a quality leisure activity. We are giving children a safe space for play. We are giving children an opportunity to be mentored as well. And I'm so excited about this because it's my passion to get children to read and write. Thank you. So hello, I'm with a wonderful young woman here, Smart, who is representing Kumasi, all the way from Kumasi to Tekan. Can you please introduce yourself and tell us what you do?
Okay, I'm Paulina Folimeje, working in Techiman, actually, that is where I work. Okay. And we provide financial services to small enterprises. By financial services, I mean we encourage people to go and save, that is, we mobilize deposits from people. And out of that pool, we intend to give credit facilities to small enterprises to, of course, expand their businesses and improve their lives. So that's basically what we do.
Wow, so how has this experience been like?
Yeah, it's been an exciting experience because one, I've learned that there is the need to get enough and relevant information, stay updated, because you cannot afford to operate in a vacuum. You have to get the needed market information, and you have to leverage on the networking, because it's been an interesting networking experience, I must say. And then you have to internationalize your dreams, your projects and ideas. You don't just have to stay in the corner, be in your comfort zone. You just have to think, that across the board, because someday, sometime, you're not just doing that for the small community, but then you get to expand to other countries as well, especially bringing together West African countries. I think it was a splendid, a platform to expand your dreams and across the world. So yes, it's been that interesting networking experience.
Now, you are a woman, and in most situations, women and technology don't go very well together. So how do you plan to send back what you've learned to other young women like you back in Techiman?
Okay, personally, I'm enthused and I'm excited about talking to people, especially young ones, of course, because we're working in such smaller communities. People, especially the girls, they are not so much interested in education, pursuing it at a higher level. Let's talk about combining technology with it. So yes, in the very circle I work, I'm going to improve because I've been using technology, all this information, and credit information that we've been working with is coordinated with technology. So I'll make sure that what I'm doing, we extend it to these communities very well, so that we engage the women and the younger ladies there to embrace the whole ICT concept.
Wow. What do you think is the way forward after here? What do we do as entrepreneurs? Do we just go back and sleep over what we've learned? What do you think is the way forward? What should we do to be able to succeed with what we've learned?
Okay. I am excited about the fact that Team Measure for the MVP Session 1,
which you were part of.
I was actually in Empower, but I loved the concept of the whole measure, because some of these things, we are not new to them. We do have lots of them at different times. So what will actually make an impact? What will make this one different? Of course, that is where we have to get our key performance indicators, so that we don't just come here, go, and that is it. We have to measure the actuals, right after this program, against what has been before, so that that difference will tell us, hey, we're making a headway. Without that, we'll still come maybe some other time and it will be the same result. So basically, I am personally concerned about using the KPI so that I know that in 2014 or in 2015, this was my result. But after TechCamp and in 2016, it has been able to deliver this additional result. So that way, I know that I'm making a headway.
Okay, you've noticed that most of these events are organized by either the US Embassy or international actors. But these things being organized by like Ghanaians or maybe in Togo by the Togo government, it's not so. Where do you think the problem is coming from? Is it because of the finances, or I just think that because maybe we are not interested as a country?
Yeah, I think we should. It's a wake-up call. Of course, there has been several programs or workshops of this kind, but I think as even before I go up there at the national level, I think the corporate entities and the private, people who have already made it in that field should be interested in embracing or opening up to the younger ones, so that it will not just be TechCamp, which will be held here in Accra, but in our own community, something which could also open up to smaller, persons in that environment. So back to the national level, we will have that interest to organize, not just organize, but to really interact, to mentor younger ones, so that this concept is really felt, not just organized, but it's really felt among the country, or so to say the African continent. Because if we sit here for the US, for the international bodies to come and do it, yes they will, but then it might not have that impact as it should have been. So I think it's a wake-up call to all of us, to in our small way, wherever we are, to open up to people, or to to individuals who perhaps might be interested in becoming such, developing their entrepreneurial spirit, so that we encourage them right from there, and I think it will be carried on to the national level.
Now, you like to read, and I'm so happy you gave me a book, which I'm excited about.
Yeah.
Do you think reading is a huge issue in Africa? What can be done to at least reduce that illiteracy rate? Even those who've gone to school do not want to read.
Yeah, I was excited. Chinwe Hesi, in one of the sessions, mentioned this combining technology with reading, so that we bring it closer to the people. It becomes exciting. People nowadays, because of this technology, we prefer using some apps and then we leave the reading. But hey, I know that you cannot, you know, replace it, but yes, we can combine technology to make reading very interesting. So I think it's in our time we did that, so that we don't just leave it in our bag. The book is not just kept somewhere, but that interest is being carried through technology.
And what's your final words of advice to especially women entrepreneurs who have not had the opportunity to be part of this conference?
Okay, I'll take this from Nicole Amatefio. In her presentation, you know, as a woman, instead of there are a lot of naysayers, but you have to believe, understand what you're doing, let it resonate down to the ground. In that case, those who initially said no will actually say yes eventually. That's what I take from Nicole, and I think it's a very powerful message to women entrepreneurs, and I love that.
Thank you so much, Paulina. It's been so fun meeting you.
Thank you.
For the book, and I hope that when we go back, we can collaborate and do something back together to help not just Ghana, but Africa.
Definitely. Thank